So this is a human heart, and we're gonna first look at the blood return. So on the right side, here's our right atrium. We're looking for the right superior vena cava, which we see coming off here. And then the inferior vena cava is down here. There's the opening to it right there. Both of those are gonna pull into the right atrium. Now, in the right atrium, if I open this, basically what's happening is I'm like filleting this open. So we have part of the right atrium down here, part of the right atrium here. So in the right atrium, there's a few things to look for. The first is this hole right here. If I put my probe into this hole, the hole will go back to the posterior part. This area is called the coronary sinus. So this opening is the opening to the coronary sinus right there. And this is where all the blood from the heart circulation returns. So back to the right atrium. On our right atrium, on top of that, we have the right auricle. And I'm just trying to go in order of what you have on your table here. So this is the right auricle. Then the valve is actually also split open. So we have a portion of the right atrioventricular valve here, and then the other portion of the valve is right here. And we can tell it's a valve based on what's attached to it, which we'll talk about in a minute, but these are those chordae tendinae. So there's a portion of that valve that's really just opened right up. Then we go into our right ventricle, which here's a part of the right ventricle. And then on this side of the heart, that space beyond right here, this is all the right ventricle in there. Now, the valve, you're not gonna be able to see, but I'm gonna stick my finger through and we'll see where it goes to. But this whole pocket under here is the right ventricle. And then I'm gonna go through the valve that's found right in here, which is called our pulmonary valve. On your list, it says pulmonary semilunar valve. The pulmonary valve is a semilunar valve. You need to have the name pulmonary with it because we have two different semilunar valves. So we have the pulmonary semilunar valve, and then we go into the pulmonary trunk. Now, the pulmonary trunk then leaves the heart through the pulmonary arteries, which are gonna go out both sides because they're going to go to the lungs on either side of the heart. And then we go back through the pulmonary veins, which we have some on this side and some on this side. Now, the pulmonary veins are going to pull into this pocket right here. You can kind of see it, which is the left atrium. And it's not open, but you can see my probe sticking right in there. That is our left atrium. And we can also see it on, excuse me, on this side. So here's our left atrium, and here's the left auricle right there. And then if I open this up, we can see that opening right there. That is our left atrioventricular valve. I'll have Suzette zoom in a little bit. So there's our valve right there, and then that's gonna pull into the left ventricle. So this portion here, and then if you look at this, you can see that big deep pocket right there, which leads into this valve, which you can tell how that valve looks quite a bit different than our atrioventricular valves. For one, there's no chordae tendinae attached, but for two, you can kind of see those three pieces just put together. This is our aortic semilunar valve. And if I go through there, I'm gonna be in this guy, which is our aorta. So we have ascending aorta, aortic arch, descending aorta. Now, following in line with things, our other heart structures. So we have the apex of the heart down here. The base is on top. Our coronary sulcus. So we talked a little bit about that coronary sinus. The sulcus is the groove within that area. Then we have the interventricular sulcus, which would be the groove within this area right here. So there's an anterior interventricular sulcus and a posterior one. So basically, if I remove all this stuff, it's sitting in the sulci. So we can't necessarily see it unless these structures are removed. Our interatrial septum, inter means in between. So we're looking in between the atrium to see this layer that's separating the two atrium, and I can't go to the other side, but that's our, that area is our interatrial septum. And the interventricular septum we can see very clearly. Oh, I skipped one, sorry. So within the right atrium, we have what's called the fossa ovalis. You can see that circle right there. That's kind of, it's a little faint, but there's that circle. That is where blood will pass through the right atrium to the left atrium in fetal circulation. It's called the foramen ovale in a fetus. And when a baby takes its first breath, sometimes this won't close over, in which case that's when you hear a baby having a hole in their heart. That's that not finished over with tissue. Then we have the chordae tendineae, which I have talked about, but I'll show you once more. So here we have some chordae tendineae. Then we have the papillary muscle, which all the chordae tendineae are going to attach onto a thickened portion of muscle. So there's one papillary muscle, and then on this side you can see this guy right there is a papillary muscle. So here and here. And then our trabeculae carnae are all these other little crisscrosses found within the ventricle. Kind of down here, over here, all these that aren't the big, thick papillary muscle. We also have in the atrium these crisscrosses that are called the, pectinate muscle, thanks. I had a brain fart for a minute. Anyway, pectinate muscle right here. So let's go over our vasculature to the heart. So on the front here, coming off the aorta, we have the right coronary artery, which the right coronary artery is going to have the marginal artery. And then if we follow it, this is cut here, but it should extend all the way back into the posterior interventricular artery. So we go marginal, comes off right there. And then this isn't dissected all the way out, it's covered in fat, but then right here we can see that artery kind of hiding, trying to pick it up right now, is the posterior interventricular artery. Now the left coronary artery comes and tucks under this pulmonary trunk, and then we see it come out as the anterior interventricular artery right here. And then the circumflex artery continues around the back, which is not very clear. Now for the venous system, the great cardiac vein runs down the front with the anterior interventricular artery. So we have great cardiac vein, anterior interventricular artery. Now the small cardiac vein would run with the marginal artery, but I don't see it here. So that one's missing on this guy. And then in the back, our middle cardiac vein runs with the posterior interventricular artery. Now sometimes in cadavers, you'll actually have two of these veins run down the back. And they have different names when that happens, but for our purposes, just know that the one that runs with the posterior interventricular artery is called the middle cardiac vein.